Hey folks! In this video, you will learn the three most important aspects when describing the software architecture design process according to Automotive SPICE. If you are worried if your software architecture is sufficiently documented, then you have come to the right place. Just keep on watching. My name is Bhaskaran Amali, and I'm a principal assessor and trainer for Automotive SPICE. In my past 13 years at Kugler Maag, I have worked with people all around the globe and trained more than 250 assessors. Since I cover a lot of international projects, I have a very good insight in the different approaches worldwide. So let's jump right into the video. What is the goal of the software architecture? It is expected that you already have software requirements which describe what the software should do. The purpose of the software architecture is to define how the functionality is going to be implemented. For this, the functionality is documented in the software requirements. In short, the requirements describe the what, the architecture, the how. A lot of organizations and projects have problems understanding how to document the architecture and which elements are required. So what are the three aspects you should manage in this process? Aspect 1, architectural views. Often the architecture is a physical view, a block diagram of the software only. Especially in complex projects, which applies to most projects nowadays, this is not enough. Surely you want a hierarchical breakdown of the software which demonstrates and explains how the functional and non-functional requirements are going to be implemented in the different components and subcomponents. Other views are dynamic views, specific functional views which show a breakdown of a specific feature, state flow diagrams, interfaces, and so on. Typically, the more complex a system, the more different views are required. As the different views must be kept consistent, an appropriate UML or SysML tool should be used. The tool will support consistency checks. Aspect 2, interfaces. A pitfall often encountered in assessments is the lack of detailed description of the interfaces. Expected contents of interface documentation are names, types, units, resolutions, ranges, default values, and so on. Without this information, a proper testing of the interfaces in the integration test is impossible. Again, describing these interfaces in an appropriate UML or SysML tool will support consistency between the different views. Aspect 3, traceability. This process also requires that you ensure traceability between your software architecture and the software requirements. Normally, there's a tool break between the requirements and the architecture, which makes the traceability difficult. The purpose of the traceability is that it A. supports consistency checks, for example, checking the completeness and accuracy of the coverage of the software requirements. B. supports the impact assessment in case of change requests or bugs. And C, supports the reporting of stakeholder expectations and identify which requirements have been tested, often referred to as coverage reports. So those were the three most important aspects of software architecture. If you want to learn more about software architectural design, we have created a more detailed white paper, which you can download for free by clicking on the link below. If you are interested in Automotive SPICE, you can subscribe to this channel. We provide expert knowledge on a regular basis. And don't forget to share this video with your colleagues. Finally, thanks for watching, and good luck and goodbye.